Hello dear students and welcome back in our biology session. So we are discussing our concept, that is what? Respiratory system. Related to the respiratory system, already we have seen some points in our previous video, okay? So today we will move for the next point, that is what? We'll discuss about the mechanism of breathing, okay? How the breathing process exactly happen and how the respiration is happen, okay? So let's see. So there are the different organs, okay, how the organ system is get formed. So many organs comes together and then it forms the different organ system, okay. So like that, respiratory system also consists the different organs like nose, nostril, nasal cavity, trachea, it is also called as windpipe, lungs, bronchi, bronchioles and alveoli, okay. All these are the respiratory organs, okay. All these are the organs of respiratory system, which are called as what? Respiratory organs, okay. So let's see about how the breathing exactly happen, okay. So here I am having the model of respiratory system, okay. So see, here is the nose, okay, and our nose are having two holes which are called as what? Nostrils, okay. So with the help of that two holes or with the help of the nostrils, we are taking air which is rich in the oxygen, okay. But while having the air, some types of the germs or some dust particles also we are inhaling, okay. So in our hair nose, there are the some hair which helps to trap the germs and the dust, and the clean the air can passes to the next organ, okay. So as the air passes from the nostril to the nasal cavity, it gets become warm, okay, and also it get becomes moist because the inner lining of this nasal cavity is secreting the mucus, okay. The inner lining of this nasal cavity is secreted the mucus, and because of that, what happened, that whatever the air we have inhaled, it get becomes warm also and it get becomes moist also, okay. So in this way, with the help of this nostril and the nasal cavity, the clean, pure, warm and the moist air can get passes to the next respiratory organ, that is nothing but what? Trachea, okay. It is called as what? Trachea. And this trachea is also called as what? Windpipe. This trachea is also called as what? Windpipe, okay. So this trachea, before that trachea, you can see here is one more organ, okay, that is called as what? Larynx, okay. And this larynx is also called as what? Voice box, okay. Why it is called as voice box? Because it helps to speak, okay. How we are speaking, or the sound is getting produced because of this larynx, and that's why it is called as what? Voice box, okay. So from these larynx, the air can get passed to the trachea, which is also called as what? Windpipe. Okay, so see here I am having model. So these are the nostrils. Through the nostrils, this is what? Nasal cavity. After the nasal cavity, the warm, moist, clean and air can get passes to the next organ, that is nothing but what? Trachea. Okay, next one. The trachea get branches, okay. The trachea is having two branches which are called as what? Bronchi, okay. This here you can see that the trachea is getting branch, okay. They are having the two branch which are called as what? Bronchi, and singularly we called as what? Bronchus, okay. Singularly we called as bronchus, okay. Next one. Again, these branches are having so many, or these branches can get entered into the lungs, okay. These branches can get entered into the lungs and again get further divided into so many small branches, which are called as what? Bronchioles, okay. Which are called as what? Bronchioles, okay. So see, the trachea is having two branches which are called as what? Bronchi, and singularly we called as what? Bronchus. That bronchus, when they get enters into the lungs, can get further divided into the so many smaller and the thinner branches, which are called as
bronchioli.
Okay, that branches are called as what? Bronchioli. At the end of the bronchioli, there are the so many smaller sac-like structures. Okay, so at the end of the each bronchioli, there are the number of sac-like structure, and that sac-like structure are called as what? Alveolus. Okay, so alveolus is a singular. We can call them togetherly as what? Alveoli. Okay, we are calling them as a alveoli, and singularly we call as what? Alveolus. Okay, so all these are the different parts of the respiratory system. Okay, so let's see how exactly the respiration is happen. So with the help of the nostril, the air enters into the nasal cavity. With the help of the nasal cavity, it gets entered into the trachea. From the trachea, it gets enters into the lungs with the help of what? Branches. Okay, with the help of the branches, this trachea get branched, and each branch is called as what? Branches. Next, that branches enters into the lungs. Okay, and again that further having so many small thinner branches, which are called as what? Bronchiole. Okay, which are called as what? Branchiole. And that each branchioles are having so many smaller and the thinner layer sac-like structure, which are called as what? Alveolus. And very important that alveolus are having the very fine thinner blood capillaries. Okay, or the blood cells are there, which are called as what? Capillary. Or we can say that what? Alveolus can get covered, or the alveoles are getting covered with the smaller thinner blood cells, which are called as what? Capillaries. Okay, so in this way, with the help of all these organs, the oxygen which we are taking during the inhale process, it comes into the alveoli, and with the help of the capillaries which are present in the alveoles, the oxygen can get diffused. Diffused means what? Can get mixed into the blood, and with the help of the blood, it can transport it to the different parts of the body. Okay, again I will repeat. See, we have inhaling the air with the help of the nostril, then that air comes into the nasal cavity, which air? Oxygen rich air. Then that oxygen rich air, with the help of the trachea and with the help of the branches, enters into the lungs, and in the lungs there are the so many bronchioles. With the help of that bronchioles, it get enters into the alveolus or alveoli. And alveoles means what? These are the sac-like structure. When we are getting inhale the air, it get bigger into the side. It get full with the air. Okay. And with the help of the capillaries, where are the capillaries present? Or these alveoles are getting covered with the capillaries, and with the help of that capillaries, the oxygen can get diffused into the blood, and with the help of the blood, it can get transported to the different parts of the body. Okay, so whatever the oxygen is get transported to the different parts of the body, that oxygen is utilized to break down the food and to produce the energy. That only we are calling as what? Respiration, cellular respiration. Okay, so with the help of the cellular respiration, some type of the waste materials also produced, that is nothing but what? Carbon dioxide. Okay, so that same carbon dioxide again get mixed into the blood, and with the help of the blood again it comes into the alveoli. Okay, so the carbon dioxide get mixed into the blood. With the blood capillaries, the carbon dioxide reaches to the alveolus. From the alveolus, it again reaches to the branchiole. From the branchiole, it gets transported to the branches. Through the trachea, it comes into the nasal cavity, and with the help of the nostrils, we are throwing out again the air out. That is which air? Carbon dioxide rich air, which we are calling as what? Exhaling process. Okay, so the exchange of the gases is happens into the alveolus. Okay, or the exchange of the gases is happens into the alveoli, and this is the alveoli, and this is the nothing but what? Breathing. And we can say that what? Respiration process, okay? And all these are the different organs which are taking part into this respiration process, okay? So now we'll discuss about whenever we have inhale, okay, our chest comes up. Why this happen? Because when we inhale the air, that time what happen? These alveoles are getting increased into the size. Why they get increased into the size? Because of the air get enters into the each sac, and that's why the size of the lungs is getting increased, okay? And one more thing is that to get the maximum place to increase the size of the lungs, what happen? Our ribs are there, okay? This is our rib cage. The rib cage are getting outwards, okay, like this. So to give the maximum area for the lungs during the inhalation, what happen? The rib cage are coming upward and the outward, okay? And it gives the maximum area for the lungs to get increase in the size. And at the same time, this diaphragm, which is called as what? Muscular sheet, which is present at the base of the respiratory organ, or we can say at the base of the lungs, okay? These diaphragms are getting move into the downside like this, okay? So it get maximum area for the lungs to inhale the maximum oxygen rich air, okay? So whenever we inhale, that time what happen? The ribs are getting upwards and outwards, okay? And whenever we are exhaling, that time what happen? These diaphragm, it comes to its normal position, okay? This diaphragm comes to its normal position and the ribs are going downward and inward, okay? Downward and the inwards, okay? And that is the reason when we are doing the breathing, our chest comes up. When we exhale air, it goes to its normal position. Why? Because the breathing, whenever we are doing the breathing, the ribs are also doing certain types of the movement. When we inhale the air, it becomes upward and outward. Whenever we exhale the air, it becomes downward and inward, okay? It becomes downward and inward. Whenever we inhale the air, that time the diaphragm goes down, okay? And whenever we exhale the air, that time what happened? This diaphragm comes to its normal position, okay? So also we can see that sometimes we are having the hiccups. Why we are having the hiccups? Because the irregular movement of these diaphragms, we are having the hiccups, and after certain time we are getting relief from that, okay? So this diaphragm also helps to in the respiration process, and it is nothing but what? One muscular sheet which helps to increase the area of the lungs during the process of respiration, okay? So now we'll see the exactly how the air can passes through the different organs. See here, from the nose with the help of the nostrils, we are taking air inside, then it goes into the nasal cavity. Through the nasal cavity, it goes into the larynx, then it goes to the trachea. From the trachea, it goes into the bronchi, then it goes to the bronchioles, and then it goes to the alveoli, okay? So these alveoli, bronchioles and the bronchiole, these are the parts which are present in what? Lungs, we can say that, okay? So here the oxygen can get into the alveoli and then it get mixed into the all body parts. Now we'll go in the reverse path. From the blood, now the carbon dioxide comes into the alveoli, then it will go into the bronchioles, then bronchi, trachea, larynx, then nasal cavity, and with the help of the nose we are throwing out that air outside, which is what? Carbon dioxide rich air. And then our one breath gets complete. One inhale and one exhale forms the one breath, okay? So in this way, all these things, all these organs are taking part into the respiratory system, okay? So today we have talked about the respiratory. It is the time, respiratory system. It is the time to tell you goodbye. We will meet in the next video, and for today, thank you.